No matter how many molded creatures Lucas would send out, Ethan is unstoppable. He felt prepared for any situation, whatever Lucas would have next. Ethan didn't expect the elevator would lead him to a different part of the barn. It wouldn't be a surprise if the next backstabbing trap would be right at the end of that corridor. No strings or wires, also no devices around here. Ethan's eyes were searching around, trying to catch any little thing that might be off, and therefore be a deadly trap. Ethan opens the door to the next room with caution. He directly realized the shape of a person sitting on a chair with its back to him. Stepping into that room added a new stench to the already surrounding smell. The smell of charcoal and burnt hair filled the whole room. First, Ethan didn't realize where it might come from, also because he was focused on finding any hints for possible traps. Coming closer to that person on the chair, he realized that immediately. It's a human corpse burned to a crisp. After he checked the surroundings, he saw a message, probably by Lucas. You are next. And also a number, which would be the pin code for the room where he probably holds Mia and Zoe. This sick maniac put Clancy's burnt body here to threaten Ethan. Lucas might be a smart guy, but Ethan was able to evade any trap he did set up till now. This leads directly to that secured door. Surely, again a trap.
No, buddy, this is a test of skills, so no cheating. That shit you're carrying? Get rid of it.
This is a very bad joke, right? Ethan couldn't trust his ears. Did he really just tell him to deposit all of his equipment, otherwise he wouldn't let him in? Ethan couldn't believe that he's actually listening to this asshole. He dropped all of his stuff. It seems that this bastard is spying on Ethan all the time. As soon as Ethan laid the last bit of equipment off his hands, the door opened automatically. For Christ's sake, Ethan could kick his own ass. Now he got himself captured. This is exactly the trap where he saw Clancy struggling. And of course, no Mia nor Zoe here. He outsmarted you after all, Ethan.
Play a little game. All you gotta do is light the candle and put it on the cake.
Kiss my ass.
Ethan, language. There are children in the building. Somewhere. I think. I'm not sure anymore.
It seems like it even has the same mechanisms as they were visible in that tape. Maybe everything is the same. If the combinations are the same, then Ethan has a great advantage because he watched the tape. Watching videos literally saved his life in this case. So just the valve is important here, and Ethan could remember the combination very well, since it was scratched into Clancy's forearm. Ethan felt the euphoria of success, because he outsmarted Lucas after all. He knew exactly what to do and what would happen. He couldn't wait to see Lucas' dumb expression in his face. Two simple steps. First, switch off the shower. Then, light the candle. Since he never took out the wine, there will be no oil all over the room. So just an exploding fancy cake. Ethan was all excited. He even forgot to step aside after he put in the candle. Hence the exploding cake threw him back.
Motherfucker! You're supposed to die!
What is this ticking sound? Related to Lucas, it could only mean... time bomb! There seemed to be a passage behind that cover. Take this, sucker!
That was supposed to be for you, goddammit!
This message put a broad smile on Ethan's face. This was even kind of fun. For sure the time here changes Ethan. Hopefully not into something bad. Seems like Lucas accepted his defeat. He even opened that secured door. Ethan gathered all of his equipment and was ready and armed to step forward. He also got the last missing part he needed to create the serum. Now he needs to find Mia and Zoe.
Finally. Mia? Mia! Mia!
She's alive.
Who are you? Where are you?
We're just beyond the pier, outside that room. Hurry!
Well now, Ethan!
The fuck do you want?
You? Dead? Guess that's not in the cards. Not yet.
Lucky me. Look, unless you have any more surprises up your sleeve, I suggest you...
Now that would be telling, Ethan. And I don't do spoilers.
Dick.
After his defeat, he still isn't giving up. There is no other way but to kill this guy either. Once again, Ethan needed to focus on every detail around him. Crazy Lucas is still active, and he wouldn't just let Ethan reach Mia and Zoe that easily. From here, it should be possible to reach that house Zoe was talking about. Ethan recognized the device. Luckily, he kept all the items he collected so far. This way is the perfect place to set up traps. It would be even difficult to avoid them. But he wouldn't use explosives here, because he would risk destroying the whole passage, since it's made out of wood. Ethan tried to examine every little bit before taking the main way, in case Lucas installed something on the side tracks that could harm him. Ethan raised another drawbridge, which opened the path to the boat's house. As he did this, he was assailed by a bad feeling, as if he woke some sleeping dogs with that action. But Ethan was skilled and prepared. Nothing can keep him from doing what he has to do, and whatever dogs he has awakened, he was ready to teach him to sleep again with his shotgun. Ethan was terminating them as if he never did anything else. In fact, after this, if he survives all of this, he even could work for some special forces. The jumper appeared out of the shadows in the last second Ethan could block the attack, just leaving a small scratch behind. Out of reflex, he aimed for its head and finished it off. If those were Lucas' special traps to hinder Ethan from reaching the boat's house, then he probably should find another profession, because this was lame. All the experience Ethan gathered in this property made him strong now. He was focused and straightforward, no matter what the next obstacle might be. Behind the door, he saw Mia and Zoe, and still he was cautious. No mistakes anymore. At least there are no obvious traps in this room. Ethan was fighting with his feelings. Becoming sentimental right now would be the worst that could happen.
Zoe? Zoe,
not now. We don't have the time. Do you have both ingredients?
Right here. There should be enough, right?
If we make them fast enough, my father and Lucas aren't far away. He's coming. Daddy's coming. Good. There's enough for two.
Crazy Jake is still here? But Ethan killed him.
So after we make the serum, what's next?
There's a boat outside. We'll take it through the swamp. But none of us will get very far without the serum.
Suddenly he realized that he should have burned down every last bit of him back as he fought him.
Hey, one of those is mine.
Zoe! Get your ass back to the house! I will deal with you later!
Okay everybody, that's it for this part. Part number 60 will be the next one and it's going to be intense. Stay if you want to see what would happen to Ethan if he didn't watch the tape with Clancy. And if you want to see what happens if he won't put away the dynamite. Alright, thank you for watching, leave a comment if you like and also subscribe if you want to see more. And see you in the next video, bye bye!
Ah!